Basically, I came with a lot of resources. Since we need to introduce this blockchain concept in our BTech level or at MTech level, so basically, many of the universities and institutions are offering at the MTech level and some introductory part at the BTech level. So AICT model curriculum of courses at a UG level in emerging areas were developed by All India Council for Technical Education. All our institutions are AICT approved. So it is, they may compile us to go and follow at least this model curriculum and adopt. If your institution is autonomous, you may make some few changes in this, and almost this model curriculum need to be adopted for teaching the BTech level or BTech level courses. That is UG level courses. For PG level, some specialized courses may be introduced. That depends upon the coordinators and the professors who design the course. So in this AICT model curriculum, you can find this on online also, internet also. You can type it in internet, that AICT model curriculum of courses at UG level. You will find this PDF. So in this, let us go for. So this is a blockchain course has been given. So here blockchain has been given here, like the prerequisite for this blockchain is cryptography techniques, data structures and algorithms, and introduction to programming. That means when the it can be offered to the third year or fourth year level courses, fourth year level. So they have mentioned here, the learning outcome of this is understanding the blockchain technology, developing blockchain-based solutions, build and deploy blockchain applications for an premise and for permission and cloud-based architectures, integrate ideas from various domains. So it is a general, you can say it is a general or introductory level course. It has been introduced, but in this they mainly focus on first from the starting from the introduction. I hope this introduction was covered by some other experts, some other speakers in this FDP, such as what is meant by blockchain, what are the categories of blockchain, various security aspects of the blockchain, and blockchain crypto primitives. All these are the basics and primitives that are required for understanding blockchain, because it is especially designed for maintaining the providing the security. So these are the basic things that we should be aware of. I hope we all know this content. Next is understanding the blockchain with the cryptocurrency. So because cryptocurrency is the first prototype or first application that has been came out and become popular in the academic and research community, and also in the for the application purpose, and it is backed by the blockchain. So how these cryptocurrencies are used with the blockchain was discussed in this. In this, I hope this consensus protocols and all will come under this. Basically, whenever anyone says that a cryptocurrency, then immediately they will say it's a blockchain. So cryptocurrency is different and blockchain is different. Blockchain is basically the backbone. It is just like an internet, okay? And a cryptocurrency is the application that will work with the backbone. It is just like an email, okay? Email application will work with the internet. So like that, cryptocurrency will work with the blockchain. So you may design any type of blockchain actually. So in this designing of the blockchain, you will be having the public blockchains, private blockchains, and consortium blockchains. This kind of blockchains will be there depending upon the application you are supposed to design the blockchain model. And based upon the type, that is public, private, or protected, the related consensus protocols will also be used. So usually, in case of public blockchains, you will come across there is a chance of more there is a chance of the identity attacks like CIBL attack or some other attacks. which are very popular in public domain. So there you need to have stronger consensus protocols. So proof of work is one strong consensus protocols, even though it consumes a lot of energy or lot of processing power, but still it is more we can say it is more promising consensus protocol to be implemented in the public domain. And while coming to the private and consortium, since very few that is the these two blockchains will be maintained by a few people, so consensus will be in the hands of few members. So somewhat liberal consensus protocols can be used, so such as proof of stake or maybe like a Byzantine fault tolerance, PBFT. These kind of things can be used, like what they are using in the Hyperledger and other private blockchains. And one more thing is, there is no rule that every blockchain will be supported by the cryptocurrency, or every blockchain will be application will be developed with the help of cryptocurrency. If you look at IBM Hyperledger, it won't have the support of cryptocurrency. Okay, where in case of Ethereum, it is having the support of its own cryptocurrency called Ether. Okay, where in case of blockchain, Bitcoin blockchain, if you look at that, Bitcoin is an application without any smart contracts there, but it supports only cryptocurrency. So like that, one category of application will be having one feature. Okay, so it depends upon the requirement of the users or the developers to choose what type of blockchain that you want. Next one is understanding the blockchain for enterprise. So here the IBM Hyperledger is coming into the picture here. So they are discussing about the wrapped consensus, Byzantine problem, and Byzantine fault tolerance, okay, BFT algorithms. So many consensus algorithms were discussed in this, in the third part of this course, that is model curriculum, blockchain application development, Hyperledger fabric architecture, identities and policies, membership, access control, channels. So total around 18 hours were dedicated for this. So that means you need to install the Hyperledger and you need to work with that. Installing the Hyperledger and working with it is a nightmare. So it is a very difficult. Sometimes people will spend around 1 week, 10 days, still it will not set out. This Hyperledger need to be installed. But where in case of Ethereum and other things can be installed very easily and can work. But this Hyperledger is taking a lot of energy of the programmers for installation and working. And at the same time, it is too heavy. That means around for every installation, or if something was gone wrong and if you go for reinstallation, at least 4 GB, 5 GB of space will be 5 GB of internet data will be consumed. So this is what the problem with this Hyperledger. So and to know about this blockchain and all, so list of practicals were given. So how to install the Node.js and the corresponding references are also given there. So the in such a way they beautifully modeled this curriculum here. Install and understand Docker container, Node.js, Java, Hyperledger fabric, and create and deploy a blockchain for Hyperledger fabric. So these are the links they have given. You can go through these links and some simple Hello World example, how to create Hello World example. Okay, mini project such as blockchain for telecom roaming fraud and overage management. So like that for IoT dashboard creation and creating Android app with a blockchain integration. So all these links were given. We can go through that and we can practice first, then we can teach to the students. So and here are the list of suggested books they have given. So because attending FDP means at least my as far as my knowledge is my idea is concerned, See, speakers will come and will teach and will go, but how can use in our teaching, because this is very, very important. After attending several FDPs, I also come to know many teachers will come and will teach and will go, but something should be handy so that we can use, we can utilize that and we can teach our students. So that is the reason I have projected this UG Emerging course designed by the AICTE. So in continuation with this, I am going to give you FDP material link here. I will place in the chat box. You may also parallelly open it so that it will be easy for discussion. The first one is because I will share the my experiences with while I'm teaching and what are the difficulties I faced and the solutions also. Not only problems I'm projecting, I'm also projecting the solutions also. First one is when to use the blockchain platform. Okay, so simply for the sake of some novelty or since the blockchain is the latest one, so everyone has to use that. No, it is not like that. You can open the file called guidelines for choosing the blockchain projects. So in the material link I have provided, in that you may open a file called guidelines for choosing the blockchain projects. So blockchain as a new technology, it is attracting huge demand in industry and academia. Few use cases in various industries are as follows, like financial sector, public sector, retail sector, insurance, supply chain, logistics. So these are the various areas, not only this one, there are many areas also there, but majorly the public distribution systems and governments, especially mainly focusing on making everything on blockchain. If you look at in 2014 itself, when the blockchain is not at all considered by any other country, at the time only the Dubai has announced that we want to make the Dubai city should be function on the blockchain by 2020. So you might have seen in the recent newspapers, they made the Dubai in municipality and other offices to work on the blockchain. So like that, in our country also, few areas the blockchain has been implemented. And in 2019 February, during the budget introduction, the finance minister has announced that in future you don't know who is the income tax officer, and income tax officer don't know who is the customer or the client. So without knowing the face of the client and without knowing the face of the client, face of the income tax officer, your works will be done. So how is it possible? Again, here anonymity will be there. You don't know who is who. So this is also again on the blockchain. So they are planning a very big thing in the background. Okay, they are going to make everything on blockchain. So where exactly this blockchain can be used? So if you can go to the second page of this, you are supposed to follow this flowchart. Okay, you are supposed to follow this flowchart. Then you are supposed to decide whether to use the blockchain or not for any project that you take. First start. The flowchart will always start with start. Cannot rely on the trusted third party. Are you in a position to rely on the third party? If you can rely on third party, then no need of blockchain. That means if the third party is trusted and you believe that the third party won't harm you or won't bluff you or something, then you can rely on the third party. So for that, blockchain is not required. If you say yes, that means I can't rely on the trusted third party, then is data to be stored or database is needed? So this is the question need to be answered. If this question says yes, then you are supposed to go for the next checking. If you say that data is no need to be stored, data is not required to be stored, then no, then that means the blockchain is not required. Okay. Next, if it is yes, then you are supposed to answer another question. That is, are multiple writers exist? That means, do multiple writers or do multiple participants or stakeholders will do changes in the or will participate and will contribute their changes? If so, then you have to answer another question. If it is not, if you say no, then blockchain is not required. If it is yes, then writers are known, untrusted, and have conflict of interest. That means writers are unknown. That means the stakeholders are unknown to each other. Then you have to answer the next question. Otherwise, no. If it is no, then blockchain is not required. So in any of this question, okay, this is the sequence of questions you are supposed to answer. So every question is from the starting to this fourth question. If no is there, then blockchain is not required. Okay, if all are yes, then you are supposed to go to this. Do you require access control? So if access control is required, then answer the next question. If it is access control is not required, let me answer another question. Access control is not required. And the next question need to be answered is, are transactions public? So that means whatever the stakeholders do changes, or whatever the stakeholders want to contribute something. Okay, if do those changes need to be public? Okay, if no, then we'll answer another question. If yes, do you want to compromise efficiency with respect to the immutability, and immutability with respect to the efficiency trade-off is required for you? If yes, then you go for choosing of the public blockchain. If no, then in these three conditions, if no, then you answer another question. Is multi-party consensus required? That means do multiple parties need to be participate in the consensus thing? Then if it is yes, then you go for consortium blockchain. Otherwise, you can go for construction of the private blockchain, right? So this is the flow chart strictly you are supposed to follow. And based upon your experiences, if you have any other thing to be included with the justification, you may include in this. So first of all, the first condition is a trusted third party is required for it. Okay, if you can't rely on the trusted third party, then you can use blockchain. So nowadays, nowadays they want to build their own, that is only the customer and the organization won't have direct communication without having any trusted third party. Then they can go for blockchain, and if the database is required, then they can go for choosing of the blockchain. Or multiple writers exist, yes, then if writers are unknown, that means no one know who is who, then you can go for writing of this. Then access control is required. Okay, if access control is required, then you are check for the public, whether the transactions to be made public. If yes, then immutability versus efficiency trade-off need to be considered. Yes, then public blockchain. Otherwise, you go for answering that whether multi-party consensus is required. If no, then choose private blockchain, otherwise consortium blockchain. So this is the flowchart which will give you how to choose the blockchain projects and what type of blockchain you are supposed to consider. The reason is saying that, okay, I have used the latest technology. Okay, we are working on the latest technology like this. But many of the students will fail to answer why you have used this. Okay, why you have chosen the blockchain, this blockchain. So they mostly people cannot answer. Mostly the students cannot answer. So if you can understand this, you can easily tell them that, okay, because of this, you are supposed to choose public blockchain, private blockchain, consortium blockchain. Okay, then I will move on to the next topic. How to start with the blockchain project? So start with small model. So always the blockchain project development is a spiral model. Okay, What is the advantage of this spiral model? Usually there are various models available, software engineering, software development models, like a waterfall model, okay? Rapid application development model, spiral model, okay? So usually software engineering is a very bore subject to the students. Okay, analysis, design, coding, and testing, always they will look for that. Okay, but software engineering has a major contribution in software, especially like blockchain project development. So it always starts with a small model. So always you are supposed to start with the prototype. Okay, always you are start with the prototype. So what is the advantage of prototyping? Prototyping advantage is you will get the understanding of the product. Okay, and at the same time, this prototype can be given to the clients. Clients will practice on the prototype, or will work with the prototype, and can give the correct feedback. Okay, what they require, because clients also don't know what is blockchain. Okay, even the developer know the programming language and everything, but clients may not be knowing the what is meant with blockchain and all. So it will be like a training model. Okay, prototype can be training. In the prototypes, again, two models will be there: throwaway prototypes and usable prototypes. The usable prototypes are one which will be used in the main development. Throwaway prototypes means after understanding the model, okay, that will not be used. Simply they will throw away and they'll start from fresh. Okay, they'll start from this scratch. Like that, you have to start with the prototype and slowly understand the requirements and take the feedback from the from the people. And you try to draw the dependency of the requirements, which requirement is dependent upon which requirement. Then slowly build up the application, and thereby you use the spiral model. The advantage of the spiral model is risk assessment. Okay, so you can identify the risk. Okay, what is the risk if you include this requirement? What is the risk if you won't include the requirement? And it may be related to the development risk, or maybe the finance risk, or maybe any other risk can be identified using the spiral model. So this is what the spiral model is, the best model for developing the blockchain projects. Next, how to understand the business problems. So first of all, you identify the what are the basic specific business problems, challenges that the first project will address. So scope of the business challenges to address. What are the current way of solving the business problem? Assuming the business problem is large, what specific aspects of the business problem will be addressed? Who are the business network participants involved in the in and what are their roles? And which are the roles are responsible for consensus granting? Okay, these are the things you are supposed to answer. Next one is who are the specific people within the organization and what are their job roles? So these are the things you are supposed to understand the problem, answer and understand the business problem. Then only you can perfectly build a model and can present to the client. So understanding the participants, you are supposed to answer this checklist. Who are the participants, what they access, and how frequently they will interact with the blockchain. Will there be any peer nodes? Do need web or mobile application? Because blockchain will be having again two categories, like a full client and a partial client. Partial clients means there the data will not be stored. Full clients will be having the facility of both the consensus and storage. That means data will be stored and also they are responsible for or they can also participate in the consensus process. So usually whenever the consensus process is too typical or complex, then mobile based working may not be a suitable one, because mobile will work on the battery operated, so battery may drain fast. So there we'll use the partial clients or half clients kind of thing. Only front end interface will be there, only they can see the transactions and they can send it, but they cannot participate in the mining or storages or storing of the data. So who are the participants and how frequently they will participate? Do we require mobile or web app or mobile app? Web can be done, because web apps can be done. But mobile app that you are supposed to think of depending upon the users and who will interact. Our gateways such as exchanges and data providers needed for this, do we need to integrate with the external data sources? Because many blockchain applications many blockchain platforms will not directly interact with the third party things. So always it will be dealing with the organization and client only, but the third party things will not come into the picture. What is this third party thing? Third party thing means, for example, smart contract is there. Smart contract means upon executing some condition, some event has to be happened. That is what the smart contract. Okay, the best smart I will tell you an example of smart contract so that you can understand that. I hope you may be knowing the smart contract concept. Basically, smart contract in the sense, it is a simple business logic. Okay, simple business logic. Upon executing this business logic, some transaction will happen. A simple example is, there is a insurance company which will give the insurance for the people, for the passengers. The insurance will be like this. For example, they will say that, we will provide the insurance for if you miss the flight. Okay, if you miss the flight, we will give you the insurance, provided you are supposed to pay some X amount of premium before 10 hours of the dispatch of the departure of the flight. If the flight was delayed by 1 hour at the destination point, then we will give you 5,000 rupees or the ticket fare, whichever is lower. Okay, whichever is lower. This is what the condition they have made. Now you may pay a premium of ₹500 just before the 10 hours of the departure of the flight. If the flight was delayed by 1 hour at the destination, then you are supposed to receive the travel insurance or some other amount. That is whatever they have claimed, that is ticket airfare or the 5,000 rupees, whichever is lower. But how the insurance people will know that the flight was delayed by 1 hour? Okay, so they have to access the database of third party. Okay, it is related to the airlines. Okay, you may use any airline. There is no restriction that you are supposed to use only this airline. Okay, now you may use SpiceJet or you may use Air India or you may use any other airline, you can avail the insurance. But this insurance people has to get the information from the airlines, airline authorities, that whether the so-and-so flight number was delayed by 1 hour at the destination or not. Then only they can pay the insured amount, right? Here third party access, whether this is said to be third party access, whether this kind of third party access is required for our blockchain or not. Okay, so whenever this third party access is there, that will be accessed via a technique called Oracle in the Ethereum blockchains. So like that, every blockchain will be having their own APIs or functionalities with which you can access the third party applications. So do you need to integrate with the external data sources, that is third party one? Who will operate the blockchain? Who will govern or regulate the blockchain? What is the value or incentive for each participant to join in the blockchain network? So these are the things you need to answer. Next, the participants' identities. Okay, do you need to know the users? Pseudo anonymous blockchain like Bitcoin does not require user identities to be verified. So if user identity to be verified, then in what way you will identify this, verify these identities? In most business use cases, some form of identity is required. In public blockchain, what kind of thing? In private blockchain, what type of identities to be verified? In how many ways it will be verified? All these things you must address first. Next is understanding assets and transactions. What are the assets that need to be safeguarded? And also, what are the key information associated with those assets? And what are the transactions involved, between whom that need to be addressed? Defining the transactions, what type of transactions, like invoking of the transactions, what are the queries will be fired by the clients or customers? Okay, do you need to access control access to these functions based upon the participant types or roles? Okay, it is just like in our databases also, whenever you are writing the RDBMS SQL queries, a clerk or accountant cannot view the manager's salary. So this is the condition, right? Like that, what are the access controls are required to maintain? So what are the main steps in current workflow, and how these are executed by the business network participants? What are the expected benefit of applying blockchain technology to the business problem? What legacy systems are involved? Because we cannot, since you are using blockchain technology, we cannot replace existing infrastructure of any organization. So do you require the integration of your blockchain with the legacy systems? That means which are already using in the organization from ages. So whether these are things to be replaced or not. If so, what is the cost of replacement? And if the cost of replacement is more than the cost of development, then what is the need of changing that? So all these things you are supposed to address. So finally, cost benefit analysis. This is the first zeroth step in software engineering, feasibility study. Is it worth doing? Whether doing this particular blockchain project is worthful or not. So the cost benefit analysis need to be analyzed. So these are the things that has to be addressed whenever you go for developing of any blockchain projects. Here I have given two case studies. First case study is, you can go through the case study. I will give you 5 minutes time. You can go through the case study. Consider the following two case studies. Case study one, a group of fresh graduates plan to start a startup with a name E-Ride. The objective of the firm is to provide electronic scooters for rent in metro cities. Initially, they plan to start the services in the cities with the metro rail facility. The initial idea is to establish offices near each metro station. Customers can pick up scooters from any metro station and can leave it at any metro station. Customers need to ride the scooters by themselves. Okay, E-Ride firm started both web and mobile based applications to avail the customer services by the customers. To avail services, first customers need to register in the app by providing valid identity, an account opening fee of ₹1,000 and a minimum deposit fee of ₹1,000. Always customers need to maintain ₹1,000 as a minimum deposit fee in the account to avail services. Upon opening the account, an account number will be issued to an e-card with an e-card. The customers can search for availability of scooters via the app. The registered customers will get a 10% discount on each ride made above 10 kilometers. Once the scooter is deposited at any metro office, an e-bill will be generated and the related amount will be deducted from the minimum deposit fee. And GST of each bill is automatically credited to the government account. Right, so this is not a complete description. It is a general it's a description of a case. Now the questions need to be answered answer the following questions with proper justification. The first question is, does implementation of blockchain benefit the above cases? Above cases means I have discussed only one case. I have told you, I have explained only one case. But second case is also this, that we'll see afterwards. What type of blockchain suggested? Identify the roles or stakeholders in these cases. define the responsibilities of the roles or stakeholders. Is there any possibility of using smart contracts in these cases? If so, list them with proper logic. List functional requirements of these cases. In your opinion, what are the security and audit procedures that need to be incorporated in these cases? Develop smart contract code using Solidity or Hyperledger Composer. Show the step-by-step plan of integrating the smart contract code with the DApps. Last 8th and 9th is require at least 15 classes for explanation of Solidity code, Hyperledger Composer code, how to integrate the smart contract with the DApp. At least it require 10 to 15 lectures at least. So since that much time is not there, so what I will do is I will ask you to answer the first 7 cases, which you can easily answer. Does implementation of the blockchain benefit the above case? So obviously the implementation of blockchain can benefit, because here there is no third party. Only the organization, and that is the e-bike or e-ride, and the clients. There is no third party. And you need to store the data also. Is the data to be stored? Obviously, data is also required. Are multiple writers exist? Obviously, multiple writers are there. Multiple customers can do this. Writers are unknown. Obviously, the clients are unknown. You don't know who will take the bike and who will go for that. Access control not required. Okay. So access control is required. So that is the reason we are going for here. Is multi-party consensus required? So it may be no. Okay. So we may focus on private blockchain. But sometimes a multi-party consensus is also required. The reason is the client wants to check it. In our case here, the client wants to check whether the bill what I have paid, its related GST was credited to the government account or not. Okay. Or if this kind of verification need to be done, our government want to check whether how many bills generated, how much GST was created. Okay. So here some multi-party consensus is required. So it is going for the consortium blockchain. So we'll end up with this case, that this case required the consortium blockchain based development, so that apart from organization, or that is e-ride and the client, here government involvement is also there. So the government involvement is only up to whether how many bills generated and how much GST was deposited. This is the only the work of government to do in this. So that much consensus, that much access is required for the government to view the things. Next one is identify the roles or stakeholders in these cases. Who are the roles? The clients, the e-ride, and the government. Define the responsibility of the roles or stakeholders. So carefully define, because it requires some brainstorming, because you have to discuss with the students and discuss and come to know the responsibilities of roles. But if it is in a real world, then you need to discuss with the clients and to get the responsibility. Is there any possibility of using smart contracts in these cases? Yes or no? So obviously there are possibilities to use this smart contract. So as I told you, a simple example, the smart contract is a condition. It's a business logic. Upon executing that logic, if the logic is true, then some transaction will happen. So here identify the logics that need to be applied. So like this, the registered customers will get 10% discount on each ride made above 10 kilometers. If they might have done a ride of 10 kilometers, then they will get 10% on the bill. So that means this is upon condition. That means it's a business logic that you need to be implemented. Like that, what are the other things that you can implement? that you may list out in your free time. List functional requirements of these cases. So in requirements also, you'll be having functional requirements and non-functional requirements. The functional requirements can be modeled using use cases. So develop the use cases for this and can get the can list the functional requirements. In your opinion, what is the security and audit procedures that need to be incorporated in these cases? So audit procedures can be done from the whom? From the client side and also from the government side. Client can do only auditing of his own bills. That means whether whatever the bill generated for him, the related GST was credited to the government or not can be verified. And government can see how much GST is generated with how many bills. Okay. And what are the other security methods that you can do? So security things such as identity verification, because to avail services, first customer need to register in the app by providing valid identity. The identity may be Aadhaar card or maybe PAN card or maybe any other government recognized identities. Okay, who will verify again? The verification will be done again by the e-ride, that is the e-ride representatives. So like this, you need to list out what are the services, okay, what are the services, security features required and auditing, other auditing procedures required. Again, this requires some brainstorming, then only you can get the things. We cannot get everything in on spot, like 2 minutes, 3 minutes, like that. But with careful brainstorming, we will get many things, many suitable or required security and audit procedures. Well, coming to the second case, a product manufacturing company wants to promote their products with multi-level marketing. I hope you, everyone aware of the multi-level marketing. I don't want to name the companies and all, but many companies will go for this multi-level marketing. They will sell the markets, they will sell their products via this chain marketing only. They won't place some, they won't give dealership or they won't place some open outlets or something. But only via mouth publicity only the products will be sold. And that representatives will also eat our brain. You join this chain and you will get so many lakhs of rupees, thousands of rupees, and you will get these products and all. So by this time you come to know who is that. So this multi-level marketing, anyhow, multi-level marketing is a very good thing, but there should be a outlet should also be there. Without outlet, how can one perform multi-level marketing? So a product manufacturing company wants to promote their products using multi-level marketing. The structure of MLM is as follows. Anyone who is interested in multi-level marketing should first get approval from company's marketing manager and can start marketing office. Company has fixed 500 ways. So here ways is the smallest denomination in the Ethereum. Okay. Previously I have used rupees here and here I am using ways. Okay. Way is the smallest denomination, like how 1 rupee is having 100 paisa, 1 paisa is the smallest denomination, like that. 500 ways is the general way of describing the denomination. So fixed 500 ways are the franchise. The franchise can build small groups for daily marketing purpose. Franchise can join members in the group. In addition, the approved group members can also join any other in it. For this, the new entrant need to pay 100 ways as joining fee. Okay. If franchise joined the new entrant in the group, then 100% joining fee is directly credited to his or her account. Otherwise, 30% of the fee, joining fee, is credited to the franchise. And remaining 70 is credited to the group member who joined the new entrant. Okay, here franchise will get 30% and the one who joined the new entrant will get 70%. That is the share they will get. Okay. The same here is applicable on the products sold by the franchise and group members. not only joining amount, but also on the products also. That is the benefit on the products. Okay. So further, now I think you might have got why the products of such multi-level marketing are too high. Okay. So that much benefit will be there. That much profit margin will be there. So they will share that profit margin. Further, maximum group size is fixed to 50. That means for every franchise, the group size that is maximum can be fixed to 50. Here many condition, many things I have not included. One person may leave one group and may join another group, and like that also you can extend this case study, but I have not given because when the maximum group size is fixed to 50, after 50 you cannot do any transaction. Okay, so if some group member leaved one group and joined another group, what is the case and all like that, if you can add, then it will be a lengthy case study. So for time being I have limited only to this case study. In this also you can implement, you can also answer this: does implementation of the blockchain benefit above case? Yes, because there is no third party here. The multi-level marketer, that is company, and the client is the one. So there is no third party is there involved in this. So you want to build up the trust between these two. So blockchain is required. So data need to be maintained. So database is required. What type of blockchain suggested? Whether it is a private blockchain or public blockchain. Here no one is coming and looking after your transactions. So you are only the boss. That is, franchise is the boss, and the group, that is the marketing manager, is the boss. So here only few people are there who are the bosses. So private blockchain is sufficient for this. Identify the roles of stakeholders in this class cases. So identify the stakeholders, the group members, the franchise manager or marketing manager, this kind of thing. Define the responsibilities of each. Again, it requires brainstorming. Is there any possibility of using smart contracts? Yes. So many smart contracts you can use, because company has fixed 500 ways condition need to be checked. Okay. And for example, what is the case if they deposited 800 ways? Okay. Rest 300 ways has to be returned back. Okay. These are all the conditions are there here, like this. New entrant has to pay 100 ways. If franchise join new entrant directly 100%, otherwise 30-70 share. So all these are, again, you can frame it as a smart contract. Okay. Next is list the functional requirements. Again, it requires brainstorming. You need to list out the functional requirements. Develop the use cases and list the functional requirements. In your opinion, what are the security and auditing procedures need to be incorporated in these cases? So many auditing procedures will be there. So what is the case if the franchise go fraud? What is the case if the group member go fraud? Okay, what is the case if the marketing manager itself go fraud? So all these things you are supposed to incorporate the security procedures. I hope you got how the cases will be built and how the things will be answered. With respect to the guidelines, choosing guidelines of the blockchain development. Next is installing Ethereum and Truffle on Windows 10 and installing Ethereum dApp environment. So this is the installing of Ethereum dApp development environment. So this is a step-by-step procedure. If you want to install the Ethereum and develop a decentralized application development environment, first you have to install the Ethereum, then wallets, Chrome browser, MetaMask, Node version manager, Solidity compiler, Truffle IDE. So step-by-step I have given the instructions how to install the Ethereum. So yes, any doubt? Okay. So here, these are the steps you are supposed to follow for installing Ethereum, and just to copy paste directly, and you can install the Ethereum. At the same time, this is the Mist is the browser. Mist is the wallet. which is an official Ethereum wallet. So few people will use Gnash, and some people will use some other wallets. So Mist is the official wallet for the Ethereum. You may use this. Next one is some of the packages in Ethereum will not work on some node versions. So you may switch between the node versions on which those modules will work, like installing node version manager. So you install the node version manager and you can shift between the node versions to work with the Ethereum APIs and packages. So that I have provided here. Next one is installing Web3.js, npm install -g web3. Next is Gnash C client, that also I have given here how to install that. Then Solidity compiler, if you want to install the Solidity compiler, so you can use npm package, node package manager, and install the Solidity compiler. Next, if you want to develop your own private chain and you want to run your own server, HTTP server, for this you require a HTTP server. You may install a HTTP server like this. NPX, and this is interplanetary file system. This is a very beautiful file system where you can upload the files and you can simply attach its hash and include in the blocks. So currently the IPS platform, IPFS, interplanetary file system platform, will support a maximum size of 100 MB to upload into it. So you can get the details of how to install the IPFS desktop and installation by visiting this website. And these are some references. And I have, these are the references. You may go through these references and you can get some more information about the Ethereum and dApp development, dApp installation. Next, installing the Truffle on Windows. Here, so far what I have discussed is installing the Truffle, this Ethereum and Truffle and our dApp development environment on Linux platform, especially the Ubuntu or Debian level. Here, I have provided a file called installing Ethereum and Truffle on the Windows 10. You can also install it on Windows 10, no need of Ubuntu also. I have provided the documentation how to use this. For this, you require Chocolaty framework. Okay, open the command prompt as an administrator. Okay, like open the command prompt as the administrator, and that is in the shell mode, that is command shell mode. Okay, copy the PowerShell mode. Okay, PowerShell mode, you use it. Copy the following command to the command prompt and enter to start a Chocolaty installation. Just as it is, you copy and paste on the command prompt so that the Chocolaty installation will start. This is, I'm telling, pertaining to the Windows 10. Once the installation is successful, update the packages using command. The Chocolaty packages need to be updated. Once the Chocolaty packages are updated, then you start installing the Node.js, Git, and Visual Studio Code and npm. Then you install npm node package manager and Ethereum JS, test RPC and Truffle. So that means for all these things, the container is the Chocolaty framework. Without Chocolaty framework, you cannot do all these things. So Chocolaty framework, first you are supposed to install. You are supposed to install rest of the things under the Chocolaty framework. Then go to the installation of the Ethereum. Test the installation of the Ethereum. In command prompt, run the command getH and start the services. Run the Truffle version and test RPC. So then you can create a Truffle demo as a directory and run the code dot. So the Visual Studio code will start and you can start typing the Solidity programming or Solidity smart contract development. So this is the installing of an Ethereum and Truffle on the Windows 10 platform. Next one is installing the Hyperledger. This is not my topic to discuss. But installing of Hyperledger is a very difficult task. So first of all, you have to install the Docker, then install the fingerprint then API sudo apt repository, then update this apt repositories, then Docker updates, and Docker Composer need to be installed, Golang need to be installed, Node.js, npm, and the Composer client, Composer REST server, Hyperledger Composer, and Composer Playground need to be installed. So this is the, these are the instructions and steps that need to be followed to install the Hyperledger fabric. Okay. So while coming to this exercise on this smart contract, the second exercise, if you look at it, okay, second exercise, it's a complete description I have provided here. That is MLM underscore problem statement exploration. MLM underscore problem statement explanation. So here the explanation is like this. There are four roles according to the problem statement: company, manager, franchise, and member. Okay. So, and expect a manager, everyone has their own account to hold fee and profit share. Discussion on the each role is as follows. This is the discussion I have provided here. What the company has to do, because we need to define what are the roles of the company, and what are the roles of the stakeholders of the project. That is franchise, manager, marketing person, and other people. So I have provided this. You may please go through this requirements and that is description. And if you want to add anything in this, you may add it. But provide your validation or what's called justification why you are adding it. Because this I have formed with some brainstorming with some people and all. But whatever the idea that I got, I have placed here. But after reading it, if you got some new idea, you may include in it. And also please intimate me that I have included in this. So I will also, I can also do some work on that. So next is manager related thing, franchise and franchise related thing, member and member related thing. Separate mapping and data structures are maintained for accessing the details of franchise and members, because franchise and members in future, if they want to change, or if they want to merge, or if the member want to go from another one account to one franchise to other franchise, then there should be some modularity, there should be some flexibility. So that will be achieved only by a modularity. So that is the reason separate mapping and data structures are maintained for accessing the details. So by foreseeing the requirement, I have done like that. Once the destructor is called, the relative entries are removed from the data structure. Anyone who is interested to join franchise can directly apply for membership via mentioning franchise address. Because in future, a member who joined around 30 members may feel that, I have joined almost 30 members. Why can't I get a franchise and I have start my own franchise? So they may think like that. So that is the reason such kind of flexibility is also added in this. So you may refer to the mlm.solve solidity code that I have developed this. I won't guarantee this this mlm.solve to be used at your own risk. I have made the code and I applied on the local machines. It is working good, but it was not tested on the large scale. Okay, so that is the reason you may use it at your own risk, or you may use it for the understanding purpose. The following program is not professionally tested. Use at your own risk. So this entire code, and this is a problem statement. The same problem statement was mentioned, and here I hope this time is not sufficient for at present to explain every concept here. This is just like the Java class or something, like how class account that you write in that. If you want to write a contract account. And here these are the data types that are available in the Solidity code. So whenever you write any Solidity, you are supposed to mention the pragma Solidity greater than or equal to 0.5.0. That means I'm going to use the APIs and packages, libraries that are greater than 0.5.0 of the Solidity language. So here, this is we can say this is a hybrid language like Java programming and JavaScript. It will look like both of the things. So it is like a hybrid one. So function external payable. Payable functions are one which are automatically payable if you mention the amount. Next one is constructor. Here constructor, like our class constructor, here also constructor will be there. The constructor will take the initialize the parameters. Here get balance, get owner, these are the bean methods. In Java programming you might have seen getter method, setter method and is method. Like that we can mention get set methods. Check the validity, check balance validity, transfer balance, kill function. I have mentioned why I have used the kill function in this particular thing. Okay. Kill function is especially used to destroy the smart contract. Okay, don't call kill function always. If without proper account settlement or money settlement, if you call kill, then the amount will be vanished. So that is the reason you should not use the destructor always. So when you are calling destructor, you must be very careful. Kill is nothing but you are going to destroy the smart contract. So that is the reason before destroying, what I did is transfer balance. Whatever the leftover balances are there, all the balances will be returned back to the customers or some other thing, franchise or group members or maybe any other one who involved with the system. Then self-destruct of address of this. So this contract will be destroyed by itself after transferring of the balance is successful. Now this is the account. This is with respect to the account. And now I'm going to use this account in the multi-level marketing, MLM. Now here, franchise fees is 500 ways, which is fixed. Membership fees is also 100 ways, which is fixed. Franchise share is 30 and member share is 70. Group size is 25, I have mentioned here. You can change it to 50. And here also structure is there. Struct company. What are the features available in the company? For every variable, I have mentioned the comment also. You can go through this comment and you can understand what is this. Next is struct franchise. This is for the franchise structure and this is for the company structure and this is for the member. This structure is for the member. And now these are the data structures to map the company to with the franchise with the group members and members with the with the individual members. Then constructor for the company, that is MLM. Then manager availability, is manager, get address of the company, okay, recruitment of the manager, check the franchise fees, check the manager availability, applying of the franchise, is valid manager, okay, check franchise, approved franchise, okay, these are the functions I have written. Like that, get registration balance, get franchise pin code, get the franchise size, all the getter methods, setter methods, okay, all these were implemented in this. So this code I have implemented. I'm giving you for your study. You may go through this. You can go to this on Solidity compiler. Remix Solidity. You can copy paste there and you can try there. Okay. One thing for everyone, I can say that instead of going for complete development and all, if you want to test only this smart contract, okay, copy the code of the smart contract and paste it in the remix.ethereum.org. Okay, and select. Select the Solidity package as the what you call, where is this 5.0 0.5.0, solidly compiler. Okay, it's not opening Remix IDE. So Remix is the online, Remix is an online IDE. You can use it. Okay, here this online Remix IDE will provide you facility for the Solidity pipeline. Okay, you click on Solidity. MLM not solve. Paste here and go to this Ethereum JavaScript. Here this is 0.5.0. So select the compiler 0.5.0. Okay, and compile. Okay madam, here contract. Okay, accounts. So you look at MLM and account, two things for you. So you can deploy this contract. Okay, account is there and MLM is there. Madam, you have to give the input now, madam. First of all, you need to give this. For example, these are the accounts. Temporary accounts will be given by the Solidity, Remix ID. You choose whatever the thing is. Okay, and I want to start the MLM or this one. Okay, and so for this MLM, what is the constructor that I have to see? So MLM construct, the account constructor. Account is the constructor is taking the address. Okay, account constructor is taking the address. So that must be supplied here. Okay, and go for deploy. Okay, then the deployment, whatever the gas fee will be there for the deployment, that will be deducted from the account. Okay, so like that you can test. You can give the parameters here and values here. Okay, and deploy so that that contract will be deployed. Okay, so this is the way you can quickly test. But if you want to do in a large scale, then you require a front end and Web3JS linking. Okay, and backend server. These are the things required. If you want to quickly test the Solidity code, then this is the way. Okay, madam. Next one is this code is also I have provided in the materials. Next one is very happy thing that I want to give you. very interesting thing here. What I did is I have created a OS image, okay, which consisting of the Hyperledger, this Ethereum, all the things. Okay, I have placed in my Google Drive. So what you can do is I am placing that drive link here. This was developed on the Bodhi Linux, which is a Debian variant. You may download this. It is around 5.1 GB something, where I have installed everything in that. So you may run on the virtual machine. I have provided the instructions also how to install this on virtual machine and run. I am providing here with the Bodhi Linux image, with Ethereum, IBM Hyperledger and other required tools installed. You may follow the steps given below to set up the image on your computer. So you just follow the steps and The Bozy Linux image username is user and password is 123456. Okay. And you can practice the programs in the virtual machine. And the same image can also be used students also. You can also give it to the students. If you want to set up a lab for the blockchain, you can also do it. So here, creation of the account error encoding, because we have not mentioned any address here. So it is giving you error. Okay, you are supposed to mention the address. So here the account was created and 0Y data was detected. So previously all are 100 ethers. You have now 99.99999666641 ethers. That means that much gas fee was detected from this account after deployment. You may work with this. You select the compiler as 0.5.0. I have already given the link, madam. I will give you a separate mail. You may forward to the participants also. Okay. And how to use that virtual machine image, and what are the softwares and tools, how to upgrade that. I have provided a video. I have made a video also. You may go through that video. I will give you that in the comment box. So blockchain platforms installation and setup for virtual machine image description. You can go to this YouTube video. So FDP material I am providing in this link. Again, the one who came late or joined late may also access this. FDP material, you can open this FDP material. In this FDP material, you will find this one. Reference underscore links and also FDP underscore resources. In this FDP underscore resources, you will find the image link. Okay, Bozy Linux OS image. You can download from this link. Okay, and you can see about this image, how to install it and how to set up and how to update it with this video. So with this I have intention of explaining many things, but I feel I have provided some sufficient information.